The High Committee meeting is currently underway. Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj, Home Minister Rajnath Singh and Finance Minister Arun Jaitley is present at the meeting. Remember, this is coming at a time where the Indian Air Force has struck certain terror camps in three regions, Muzaffarabad, the Chakoti as well as Balakot. Remember this operation that took place at around 3:30 a.m. with almost 12 Mirage 2000 fighter jets striking these terror camps. Now, those are the visuals that you're seeing on your screens of a high-level committee meeting that is underway, chaired by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. In understanding the entire situation, he's been briefed by Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj, who's also present at the meeting. Also, Home Minister Rajnath Singh and Finance Minister Arun Jaitley all present at the meeting in the aftermath of this attack that has taken place. The Indian Air Force carrying out a strike in the terror camp. Now, there are preliminary information that is coming in, and we are still awaiting an official confirmation from the Indian government, which is yet to issue an official statement on this strike at this point. But news that is coming in, of course, being of a high-level meeting that is currently underway, chaired by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Sushma Swaraj, Home Minister Rajnath Singh, Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman and also Finance Minister Arun Jaitley attending this very high-level meeting that has taken place. All right, going across, Mr. Ranjit Rai, former director of the IB, sir, if you look at the locations where right now the preliminary information coming out and sources indicating that Balakot, Chakoti and Muzaffarabad terror pads across the line of control have been completely destroyed, how significant are these locations, particularly if we talk about Balakot, which perhaps even goes beyond the Pakistan-occupied Kashmir?
Well, as director of naval operations and intelligence, not IB, I can certainly tell you that it's been a powerful action. A lot of damage must have been done, and only then will details come. But surely at this particular juncture, every armed force will be going in to be prepared for any eventuality. No service. In 1971, we were not ready for war. Field Marshal Manekshaw had to take time, and therefore it will be much faster in the current situation, but surely with a heightened attack, you can always, for the defense of the country, get into high alert. So I think this meeting is going to be very, very significant, which you have been reporting, because they will be considering what you in Mirror are talking about. How much, what do we do? You remember in Parakram, we got a mobilization. Okay. And so that will be the crux of what India does and what Pakistan responds in view of the Chapter 7 of the United Nations, allowing India to do self-defense.
But Mr. Rai, what is perhaps the possible implications of it? On diplomatic front, there has been all attempts made to isolate Pakistan. There has been world condemnation coming in post the Pulwama attack. Now with a fresh strike by the Indian Air Force, striking all the terror camps in those regions, what perhaps do you think will be the possible implication of it globally?
Well, I think you as Mirror have asked me the most valid question. Telephones must be ringing to China, USA, and Europe, explaining our position, why we did it, what we did it. Possibly a United Nations Security Council meeting will take place, because we know the world does not want to escalate in India and Pakistan, which is supposed to be the most volatile area with nuclear bombs on both sides. So the question that you ask is about very right. All our ambassadors must be on their toes. If you have served in an embassy, the local government will ask, please explain what this was all about. There would be a press release on the very subject, which I think only after the high-level meeting, what the government exactly wants to say, therefore, to the best of my knowledge, there's total silence from the government of India. It's somebody from the media hall which is reporting and telling us what's happening.
Absolutely. And Mr. Rai, as you pointed out, it is going to have a lot of significance in the global arena as well in understanding where the world stands, because In the aftermath of the Pulwama attack, we have seen several countries come out in support. In fact, France even went ahead to say that Masood Azhar must be put in the category of global terrorist. But we haven't seen that step really coming at. Perhaps with this particular strike, as you pointed out, can we expect some heads to roll, particularly in the direction of eliminating terror in these areas?
Well, Pakistan gave a facade of action by putting Masood Azhar into some sort of a custody threat, but it also looked for proof of what happened at Pulwama. They have never accepted and always called them non-state actors. But this time, with this attack, the whole world is going to be thinking of what next. Whenever you have such action, whether it is in Syria, whether it is
Absolutely.
In Iraq, there is always a thinking of what will that nation do next. Will it take it lying down? Will it react? And after all, there is a military in Pakistan which has to show its teeth if the Indians have also shown their aerial teeth.